It is indeed a great day, a day of great pride for the officers of the 67th batch of the IRS Customs and Central Excise to call on the President and to get an opportunity to listen to the words of wisdom from the Honorable President of India as they start their career in the service of the nation. Sir, I am very pleased to say that the National Academy of Customs, Indirect Tax and Narcotics has been grooming the officers on legal and technical subjects, international best practices, use of information technology and soft skills. A fundamental part of our training has been the imparting of basic values and a sense of responsibility to the citizens at large and to make the country proud by providing a transparent, humane and responsive indirect tax administration. Sir, it gives me great pride in sharing that these young officers of the 67th batch are trained in GST and have been in the forefront of implementation of GST in right earnest. They have been helping the state governments as well as the taxpayers to understand the new regime. Sir, I would like to express my deepest gratitude to you for sparing your valuable time from your busy schedule to address these young officers. I am confident, sir, that your directions and advice to these young officers shall inspire them to serve the nation with utmost commitment and dedication. Jai Hind.
It's indeed an honor, sir, to be here in this august hall, and I have the proud privilege to present the 67th batch. As you have told you, sir, in the private brief, there are 147 of them all, out of which 115 are gentlemen officers and 32 are lady officers. The large breakup of the batch, with this batch we had trained 5 Bhutanese officers sponsored by the Government of India. Unfortunately, they are not here with us. The academic breakup of the officers is that, sir, predominantly they are from the engineering stream, around 69%. 69 officers are from the engineering stream. Medicine stream is 16 officers. The MBA and PGDM, another 16 officers. Humanities, consisting of arts, graduates and postgraduates, around 23. Science streams represent 16 officers. Commerce, 1. Law, 5. And Chartered Accountant, 1. They represent almost the multidisciplinary approach, and they come from some of the prestigious schools and academies of the country. During this training, sir, we have, apart from the indirect tax training on customs, central excise, service tax and GST, we have taught them on allied acts like CRPC, IPC and the environmental laws which they are required to enforce in the field. We have also taught them public finance, accounting and audit, international conventions, they're like WTO, WCO provisions. We also enforce narcotics in the field, sir, and NASEN is an accredited institution for narcotics. We are also WCO's accredited regional training center. We train them in arms and physical training with the NPA and NISA. During the field attachment, they have been to the borders of this country, not only just land custom stations, ITBP, BSF, and Sima Surakhya Bal. They have visited Coast Guard, had WI, the Wildlife Institute attachments, so that the approach is that they not only just invent, they are also familiar with the terrain, the tough terrain, the customs formation, the land custom station facing all the neighboring countries. Apart from that, sir, with this batch, we have given them an international exposure, since customs is about international best practices and import-export goods from different countries. We enforce the laws relating not only customs but environment. We had an exposure with this batch with the Paris Sciences Po University, with a visit to WCO in Brussels, and also the Rotterdam port, which is one of the modern ports in Europe. Apart from all of the training, sir, the values are the most important component. I can assure you, as the DG of the NASEN, sir, the guiding force or the guiding motto of the academy has been to produce clean, capable and compassionate tax administrators who would administer tax with just and fairness, tempered with mercy. They have completed the training. This is the last leg of the training for which, sir, the passing out parade will be happening on 1st of the October. With that, they will go out to the field as full-fledged officers. We believe we have created a band of dedicated officers who are ready to nation serve, waiting for your words of wisdom. Thank you. Jai Hind.
आज भारतीय राजस्व सेवा का यह 67वां बैच ऐतिहासिक दरबार सभागार में भारतीय गणतंत्र के सर्वोच्च प्रतीक अर्थात आपके सन्मुख उपस्थित होकर स्वयं को गौरवान्वित महसूस कर रहा है। माननीय, आज से लगभग 20 माह पूर्व देश सेवार्थ कर संचय का ध्येय मंत्र हृदय में स्थापित कर हमने राजकीय सेवा के पथ पर चलना प्रारंभ किया था। राष्ट्रीय सीमा शुल्क, अप्रत्यक्ष कर एवं नारकोटिक्स अकादमी नासिन द्वारा परिष्कृत एवं प्रशिक्षित हम प्रशिक्षु अधिकारी राष्ट्र सेवा हेतु कटिबद्ध हैं। हम आभारी हैं हमारी अकादमी के कि जिसने प्रशिक्षण के प्रारंभ में प्राप्त अदम्य साहसी किंतु अलहड़ व्यक्तित्वों को परिमार्जित कर एक निर्भीक और अडिग लोक सेवक का रूप दिया। एक उत्साही किंतु अलमस्त प्रशिक्षु से हमें एक जिम्मेदार और ऊर्जावान अधिकारी का निर्माण किया। एक अधिकारी के रूप में समग्र व्यक्तित्व विकास के निर्माण हेतु हमें अकादमिक एवं व्यवहारिक दोनों आयामों पर प्रशिक्षित किया गया। मानवीय संवेदना एवं समानुभूति विकसित करने के लिए प्रशिक्षण में समय समय पर साहित्य, कला एवं संस्कृति का पक्षों का भी समन्वेषण किया गया। आदरणीय राष्ट्रपति महोदय, हमारा यह बैच अत्यंत सौभाग्यशाली है कि हमें विश्व के सबसे बड़े लोकतंत्र के इतिहास में हुए सबसे बड़े कर परिवर्तन GST का साक्षी और सहभागी बनने का अवसर प्राप्त हुआ। वस्तु एवं सेवा कर प्रणाली को संपूर्ण देश में सफलतापूर्वक लागू करने में भारतीय राजस्व सेवा को महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका प्रदान की गई। हमें एक राष्ट्र, एक बाजार, एक कर की संकल्पना को मूर्त रूप देकर सचमुच सेवा संतुष्टि की अनुभूति हुई है। माननीय राष्ट्रपति महोदय, देश के प्रथम नागरिक एवं राष्ट्राध्यक्ष के रूप में आप द्वारा इस महत्वपूर्ण कार्य हेतु भारतीय राजस्व सेवा पर किए गए विश्वास हेतु हम आपका आभार व्यक्त करते हैं। राष्ट्रपति महोदय, हम आपको विश्वास दिलाते हैं कि हम सेवा के प्रारंभ में ली गई शपथ को पूर्ण रूप से निभाएंगे, संविधान के प्रति श्रद्धा एवं निष्ठा को अक्षुण बनाए रखेंगे तथा अपने दायित्वों को पूरी दृढ़ता और ईमानदारी से पालन करेंगे। अंत में मुझे प्रधानमंत्री श्री अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी की चंद पंक्तियाँ याद आती हैं। कुछ कांटों से सज्जित जीवन, प्रेम प्रखर से वंचित यौवन, नीरवता से मुखरित मधुबन, परहित अपना तन मन, जीवन को शत शत आहुति में जलना होगा, गलना होगा, कदम मिलाकर चलना होगा, कदम मिलाकर चलना होगा। अब मैं अपनी साथी अधिकारी भानुप्रिया मीना को अपने विचार अभिव्यक्त करने के लिए मंच पर आमंत्रित करता हूँ। जय हिंद।
अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू ऑल। सर, इट इज़ इंडीड अ मैटर ऑफ ग्रेट ऑनर एंड प्रिविलेज फॉर अस द ऑफिसर ट्रेनीज ऑफ 67th बैच ऑफ इंडियन रेवेन्यू सर्विस कस्टम्स एंड सेंट्रल एक्साइज टू बी इन योर एस्टीम्ड प्रेजेंस। From being awed by the sheer magnanimity of this house from outside as a bystander, to be sitting inside this historical Darbar Hall. With the first citizen of India, each one of us has had a memorable journey indeed. But the most remarkable, enriching and fulfilling journey of our career and our lives started in the winter of 2015 at Nasin. Sir, when we entered the gates of our academy, we were nothing but a varied crowd of eager young minds, segregated and diverse, culturally and academically. The training at the academy has molded us into responsible, accountable, and visionary tax administrators. And today, we all stand in front of you, strong and united by the greater objective of serving this nation with courage, conviction, honesty, and utmost humility. Sir, the course designed by the Academy to achieve this comprised of extensive classroom sessions by the experienced and knowledgeable field officers and experts in the field of indirect taxation laws for an in-depth study, understanding and interpretation of the law, interspersed with attachments to various field formations across the country, to have a practical, hands-on experience of the task in hand, to understand the importance of coordination and cooperation, and develop a relationship of trust with different departments and agencies working towards the common objective of upholding and protecting the law of the land. We were sent on attachments to various agencies such as BSF, ITBP, Wildlife Institute of India, and others, including a month-long arms and weapons training at the National Industrial Security Academy and the National Police Academy. Sir, these varied experiences at such premier institutions of the country have broadened our horizons and perspectives and have inculcated the habit of keeping the larger picture in mind while discharging our duties. Sir, we have completed 4 months in our first postings as Assistant Commissioner, Customs and GST, and we consider ourselves extremely fortunate for being at the forefront at the time when the historic Goods and Services Tax was rolled out. It is a momentous time for us young officers to be a part of the implementation of the biggest tax reform in the history of this great nation. With the training imparted by Alma Mater and with the experience gained by handling the challenges head on, we as a badge assure you, sir, that we are fully capable to realize the objective of one nation, one tax, one market in its truest sense. As we now start the journey as the sentinels of our economic frontiers, we look up to you, sir, for your words of inspiration, guidance, and encouragement. On behalf of my fellow officer trainees, I take this opportunity to express my sincerest gratitude, sir, for this honor. Thank you. Jai Hind. I now call upon Mr. Teja Selu to come and share his experience.
Who we are cannot be separated from where we are from. This is a quote from Malcolm Gladwell's heartbreaking bestseller, Outliers. The word outlier is a word that resonates with me and my life in unique ways. If we go by the conventional stereotype, which we as a society are collectively guilty of falling prey to more often than not, I'm not someone by way of my geographical identity or genetic ethnicity what fits a description of a typical Indian bureaucrat. I'm an outlier. And when I say me, I am being representative of my colleagues from the northeast of India. I was born in Kohima, Nagaland, as the youngest of 6 siblings and brought up by a single mother. Since I don't want to fall into the rhetorical trap of painting a melodramatic picture, let me simply put it this way. I grew up in turbulent times in my home state. And from there, it has been a long and winding road, literally and figuratively, to this podium. During my school years, I was part of Bharat Scouts, which inculcated in me an aptitude for public service. The first concrete shape that it took was in the form of me becoming a doctor by studying medicine and graduating from the prestigious university Jipmer in Pondicherry. But I was always seeking for the broadest and highest platform for public service. And to cut the long story short, I am here in front of you today. In pursuit of a career that meets my aspirations, life took me on an enlightening road trip of sorts. I grew up in the Northeast, studied and worked in the South, and got my professional training in North and East India, to put it broadly. I would be lying if I say it was a smooth journey, that it was always pleasant, because it was not. But it has changed me, my perspective, my outlook, and my aspiration for the better, for the rest of my life. At the beginning of my speech, I quoted, "We cannot be separated from where we are. Maybe we cannot be, but my time spent across the country has taught me that we can be more than where we are from. I am from Nagaland, I am from the Northeast, but I have imbibed and gained in a huge way from all the parts of the country, and being a sum of all those parts has equipped me to be a better person and a better officer. Identities be it ethnic, religious, or linguistic, be it of a Naga, a Malayali, or a Bihari, at its root are fundamentally divisive. Independent India has challenged this conventional wisdom over the last 70 odd years of her history to take small labored steps to move forward towards an egalitarian, inclusive society. To paraphrase Martin Luther King, this is my hope. This is the hope with which I will and we all should be working for the people of India. With this faith, we will be able to carve out of any mountain of despair a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. Thank you. Jai Hind. I may now call upon my fellow officer trainee, Miss Divya Mani, to share her journey.
I'd like to share my tryst with Justini. Sir, I'm Divya Mani. I was born in a small village near Cuddalore district, Tamil Nadu. Being a second girl child with a no male sibling, it's not as easy as it sounds with respect to erstwhile social norms. But my parents made sure that their daughters are born champions who are meant to win up to their dreams. They never clipped our wings. They let us fly as I reached an engineering degree. I started to run this race. The race here was not against only my fellow aspirants, but this race is against the societal norms, prejudice, stereotypes. So as Mahatma Gandhi said, first they ignore you, then they laugh at you, then they fight you, then you win. Yes, sir, I won. So being the first generation civil servant from my village was pretty tough, but I'm glad that I have brought positive changes from my people for them. Especially the girls, my success sends a clear message to the society that girls are not here just to survive, but to thrive. They have the aspiration which need to be fulfilled as per their own choices. Now I can say with the conviction that the birth of the girl child in my village, it's not seen as a burden, it's seen as a pride. I realize that education empowers not just the woman, but the nation in large, and the learned helplessness is just an illusion that education can break. Glass ceilings, especially for the woman empowerment, is getting fragile, sir, and I broke it. Today, my parents are proud, not just about my achievement, but also because that I take care of them as a daughter, irrespective of my gender. They are happy that this phase had molded me more brave, confident, to face any challenges and raise above it. Life do not end here. We have much more height to be scaled. We don't quit easily. Every step of us will make sure we win over ourselves. We learned that we are not only the limitations we had faced. We learned how to defeat our weakness. So, we are trained to be the best version of ourselves. To sum up my experience, our deepest fear is not that we are just inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond adequacy. It is our light, not our darkness, that frightens us most. By playing small, nothing serves the world. As we liberate us from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates this world. Last but not the least, I'm a proud daughter of this India. Thank you, Jai Hind. Now I may like to call upon my fellow officer trainee, Shri Amit Kumar Singh, to share his experience.
Mahoday, yeh mere liye atyant gaurav aur samman ki baat hai ki mujhe Rashtrapati Bhavan ke darbar hall mein desh ke pratham nagrik ke sammukh apni baat rakhne ka avsar mila hai. Mahoday, main Uttar Pradesh ke Azamgarh jile mein sthit gaon se sambandh rakhta hoon. Mahoday, meri parvarish gramin prishthbhoomi mein hui hai, jahan aajivika ka ekmatra sadhan कृषि है. हर किसान की तरह मेरे माता पिता की भी इच्छा थी कि बेटा सरकारी नौकरी में आए. तमाम समस्या और जद्दोजहद के बाद जब गांव का एक लड़का शहर में पढ़ने के लिए आता है तो अनेक समस्याएं भी उसके साथ आती हैं, जिसमें सबसे प्रमुख समस्या आर्थिक होती है. पढ़ाई के दौरान यह महसूस हुआ कि इस समस्या का समाधान केवल उसको उजागर करने में नहीं बल्कि उस सिस्टम का हिस्सा बनने में है जो उसके समाधान का जरिया बन सकता है. महोदय, इसी क्रम में मुझे 4 साल सीआरपीएफ में सहायक कमांडेंट के रूप में नक्सल प्रभावित क्षेत्र में काम करने का अनुभव भी प्राप्त हुआ, जहां आधारभूत स्तर पर इस समस्या को समित करने का कार्य किया। इस वजह से मैं हमेशा इस बात के लिए संवेदनशील रहूंगा कि मेरे कार्यालय द्वारा संग्रहित राजस्व समाज के उन अंतिम व्यक्ति के हितों की सुरक्षा करें। अपने देश और समाज के प्रति अथक सेवा का यही भाव सिविल सेवा ज्वाइन करने की ओर अग्रसर किया और सिविल सेवा में चयनित होना मेरे जैसे अनेक भारतीय नागरिकों के सपनों का सच होने के समान है। महोदय, बचपन में जब भारत के राष्ट्रपति द्वारा राष्ट्र के नाम संबोधन सुनते थे और सोचते थे कि कैसे राष्ट्र के प्रथम नागरिक की आवाज़ समाज के अंतिम व्यक्ति तक पहुँचती है, आज समाज के उसी अंतिम पायदान के व्यक्ति को आपके द्वारा ही नियुक्त किया गया है। व्यक्तिगत रूप से यह मेरे लिए भावुक और गौरवान्वित क्षण है। इसके लिए 67वें बैच की ओर से मैं आपके प्रति आभारी हूँ। साथ ही इस बात का विश्वास दिलाता हूँ कि आपके द्वारा सौंपे गए उत्तरदायित्व का सत्यनिष्ठा एवं पूरी ईमानदारी के साथ निर्वहन करूँगा। जय हिंद। अब मैं अपने साथी महेश सिंगारप्पू को आमंत्रित करना चाहता हूं, वे आएं और अपने अनुभवों को साझा करें।
इट इज़ एन ओवरवेलमिंग ऑनर फॉर मी टू बी एबल टू शेयर अ फ्यू वर्ड्स अबाउट माय एक्सपीरियंसेस विद यू हियर इन दिस गैदरिंग। आई कम फ्रॉम अ विलेज इन तेलंगाना। दिस वाज अ रेगुलर विलेज विद बेर मिनिमम फैसिलिटीज, बोथ एजुकेशनल एंड मेडिकल। व्हेन आई वाज अबाउट 6 months ओल्ड, आई वाज ऑपरेटेड अपॉन बाय अ प्राइवेट मेडिकल प्रैक्टिशनर बिकॉज वी डिड नॉट हैव अ हॉस्पिटल एट दैट टाइम इन माय विलेज। And I lost my leg before I could start walking. Being a physically challenged child in a village is not so easy. You're ridiculed, you're made fun of. There are many superstitions that you have to fight against, many questions about your capabilities that you have to answer. My parents, though, fortunately encouraged me to go to school, unlike how it is for about 70% of the differently abled children in this country. My school, a government school, only one at that time in about 100 square kilometer area, it had no classrooms. This meant we had to study outside, under a tree right next to the school. The best thing about this arrangement was that we had a holiday every time it rained. It is in that school where I learned the importance of government and the bureaucracy behind it. I was given a scholarship of about 80 rupees, with which I could pay my examination fees. That sum of 80 rupees had made the difference. It made a child from a nondescript village walk all his way up to the halls of the holy shrine of democracy, the Rashtrapati Bhavan. I consciously use the word holy because I see the civil service as nothing short of a spiritual duty. I constantly remind myself of the fact that service to the citizens of India means the service to 1/6 of the humanity. I do believe that government is the biggest change agent there is, because I myself am a product of government's intervention through scholarships and reservation. It is these interventions that have enabled me to finish my graduation, attend to one of the most premier management institute of the country, as a result to be able to work in different countries before coming back to where I belong to join the civil services. I have walked far, walked long, but I do know that my journey as a civil servant is just beginning, and I do intend to still walk further with renewed commitment under the guidance of my seniors, under the ultimate leadership of the first citizen. On this occasion, I would like to thank my mother, who taught me that education is the only investment worth making. Thank God Almighty for giving me the strength to serve my fellow citizens, to take part, however little it may be, in shaping the future of this country. And to that end, I serve at the pleasure of the President. Thank you, sir. Jai Hind.
I welcome you all to Rashtrapati Bhavan. I also congratulate you on your success in a very tough and competitive exam and in your selection to the Indian Revenue Service. I have heard some of your colleagues. They have narrated not only their experiences in the academy but also about their family background. And I can say that this is when we call India as a country of diversity. I do feel that here amongst you, you do represent the true character of India. Friends, collection of revenue is critical to the task of nation building. The revenue collected by officers such as all of you is used for the development of the country, for building infrastructure in rural and urban areas, for schools and hospitals, and so many other institutions that the common citizens need. Tax collection should be a smooth process. There should be minimum discomfort to the taxpayer. That is the crux of the system. The taxpayer is your partner in nation building. Interaction with the taxpayer should not inconvenience him. As far as possible, it should be digital and without need for a human meeting. This is what we generally call it, transparency. I understand that you have taken many concrete steps in this regard. This thinking is a part of Indian tradition. As we all know, in the Arthashastra, Chanakya writes, I unquote, taxation should not be a painful process for the people. There should be leniency and caution while deciding the tax structure. Ideally, governments should collect taxes like a honeybee, which sucks just the right amount of honey from the flower so that both can survive. The training of the Indian Revenue Service, Customs and Central Excise, Probationers is very comprehensive. As our senior officers, Revenue Secretary, Mr. P. K. Das, they have also explained in detail. It covers subjects ranging from public finance and international trade to self-defense and soft skills. The training will groom you into becoming efficient managers, sensitive leaders, and motivated officers. Above all, it will equip you to make a difference to society. The National Academy of Customs, Indirect Taxes, and Narcotics has also been responsible for training officers of both the union and state governments on the goods and service tax, which came into force on July 1, 2017. In a sense, you will drive GST, which is one of India's biggest economic reforms since independence. This will also add to the unity of the country. And you have rightly said that this GST represents one nation, one market, and one tax system. This is the age of globalization and technological advance. This throws up enormous opportunities for trade and investment. It also, unfortunately, creates avenues for fraud and money laundering. It is your job to promote economic activity and curb fraud. Both those goals are important. As such, the work you do has implications for India and for India's reputation in the world as a trusted business destination with a fair and predictable tax regime. Please be mindful of this big responsibility. All of you are at the beginning of a long and exciting journey. Your careers will go parallel with our country's rise as an economic power. Your generation is truly blessed. In such times of change, don't forget the basics. You are the first and last public servants, because whatever you collect as revenue, that will also be used for your children. You are the first and last public servants, that is the servants of the people and service providers to the taxpayer. You are going to be the game changers. Number two, integrity is not negotiable. A credible tax system can only be built by credible tax officers. Wherever you are posted, I will request you to please have the working knowledge of local language. That will facilitate your dialogue with the taxpayers. Another thing which I would like to tell you, when I was a member of parliament, I happened to meet a secretary to the government of India, and as I saw a board written on his back, Hindi mein tha, Kabira khada bazaar mein, sabki mange khair, na kahu se dosti, na kahu se bair. You have to be impartial, very, very impartial. The only thing you have to remember, you are dedicated, you are honest, integrity, hard work, king, and dedication to the job. Nothing else. I therefore put you in the excellent category of nation builders, and you will be, and I am sure that you will discharge your all the ensuing responsibilities with the commitments to the nation. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
For me, it's a great honor and privilege to propose a vote of thanks on this gracious occasion. Today, the young officer trainees got the opportunity to call in the first citizen of India. Sir, you have spared your precious time to listen patiently to what they had to say of the journey of life, of the training experience, and their aspirations. Your valuable words of wisdom, which you shared with them today, will go a long way in motivating them in life. Thank you, sir. I would like to express my gratitude to Shri Kotari, Secretary to the Honorable President, and other officers of the Secretariat for providing all assistance to us in making this important event possible. I would like to thank Dr. Hasmukh Adia, Revenue Secretary, for his stellar leadership of the department and sparing time to be here. I would like to express my heartfelt thanks to Chairman CBEC, Member CBEC, and DG Nassin for the help and support in making this event successful. Once again, on behalf of myself, CBEC, and Nassin, I would like to express my deepest gratitude to the Honorable President for giving audience to the young officers. Thank you, sir.